Power Query, the split to rows is amazing, but what if we have to do that for two columns? If you try and select two columns and then split, it gets disabled, right? So here's what we have. For each invoice, we have a list of products, in this case there's six, and a list of quantities. And we want to like figure out that there's three of T, 18 of B, and so on. Now, today in Office Insiders, Microsoft 365, we have this great new function where we can split C by the commas, ampersand with a dash, split B by the commas, and then join that whole thing with a pipe character in between, and we would get this, right? That's just beautiful. Control T to make that all into a table, and we're home free. Data from table or range, we're gonna take this and split it at the pipe. So split column by delimiter, advanced into rows, click OK. Beautiful. We don't need this. We don't need this. And then here, this is just a straight split column by delimiter at the dash. OK. Done, right? Gorgeous. Close and load. But let's assume that you're not in Office Insiders and you don't yet have this. So look, while I could solve this in the Power Query editor, at this point, I just know that there has to be a better way to write this code. So I turned to Suat Oscar, author of the soon-to-be upcoming You Wouldn't Write Professional VBA Using the Macro Recorder, Would You? A Programmer's Guide to M. And we'll put a link down to this code down in the YouTube description. So here, this data will convert to table, control T, click OK. They're gonna call it table one. That's perfect because this code is looking for table one. Data, get data from other sources, blank query, view, advanced editor, get rid of what's there and we'll paste. All right, and click done. And home, close and load. All right, that's the way to do it if you're a hotshot M programmer. But unfortunately, I'm not. So we're gonna turn to my way to do it using the Power Query Editor, which is a horrible set of steps. We're making this into a table. Click OK. We'll call it Ridge Data. Data from table or range. You see that they see all those commas out there, so we have to get rid of the change type. This first query is gonna get invoice and products, but not quantities. So we take the products, split column by delimiter, split into rows, click OK. We don't need quantities anymore. And on the add column, we will add an index column from zero. All right, so this is going to just be called the products and home, close and load to only create a connection. All right, then we come back to the exact same table from table or range. This time we can get rid of the products, get rid of the change types, that way our commas come back here. Split column by delimiter, comma, into rows, click OK, good, add column, add an index column from zero, make sure that you choose the same index both times, and these will be called the quantity, home, close and load to only create a connection, good, and then just out here to the side somewhere, get data, combine queries, merge, we'll take the products, quantity, index, index, click OK, expand this so we can get the quantity out, click OK, we don't need the second index, invoice, products, quantities, home, close and load. Yep, there you go. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.